What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. In today's lesson, we're going to learn 20 homophones. What are homophones? They are words that have exactly the same pronunciation, but different meaning and spelling. Are you ready? So let's get into it. The first set of homophones is sun and sun. The first example, the sun is shining brightly. And another example for the second word is she has two sons. Be careful because a lot of people say two sons. So the correct pronunciation of hijo is exactly the same as the sun in the sky. Let's move on to plane and plane. The first example for the first word is he's afraid of traveling by plane. And the example for the second plane is I'm wearing a plain top today. It means without any pattern. Then we've got dear and dear. The example for the first word is if you like romantic movies, I recommend watching Dear John. And the second deer is an animal. And the example would be Nara is famous for its deers. Let's continue. Another pair of homophones is muscles and muscles. Exactly the same pronunciation. So the first word, we talk about a kind of seafood. For example, do you like muscles? I do. And the second word is muscles when we talk about our body. For example, I need to strengthen my back muscles. Let's continue. Number five, flower and flower. The first flower is something we need, for example, if we want to make a cake. For example, we've run out of flour. We need to buy some. And another flower is this. For example, it's such a nice flower. Let's continue. Number six, pear and pear. The first pear is a kind of fruit. For example, I prefer apples to pears. And the second pear, an example sentence, I want to buy a new pair of jeans. Let's continue. The set of homophones number seven is steak and steak. The first example, I'd like my steak well done, please. And the second steak, it's an important decision to make as there is a lot at stake. Let's move on to number eight, wood and wood. The first example is the house is made of wood. And the second example for our second word is would you like a cuppa? A cuppa is an informal way to say a cup of tea. Let's continue. Number nine, weather and weather. The first, weather, means what we have in the street outside. For example, the weather is so lovely today. And the second, weather, means if. For example, I'll be there whether it rains or not. Let's continue. Number 10, why and why. The first, why, is a question word. For example, why didn't you tell me? I could have helped. And the second, why, is a letter. For example, it's spelled with the letter Y. Some of my students find it difficult to remember that letter Y is called Y when they spell it. So a clue is to remember that it's exactly the same as the question word Y. Before we continue, a super quick reminder to subscribe to English Bits if you haven't done it yet. Click on the red button right here. Let's continue. Number 11, one and one. The first one is a number. For example, Valencia is one of the best cities in the world. And the second one is a verb in the past and past participle of win. Win, one, one. For example, who won the match? Let's move on to number 12, a very similar set of homophones, 8 and 8. The first 8 is a number, for example, there were 8 of us. And the second 8 is also the past form of the verb to eat. For example, I ate too much. Let's continue number 13. We have 3 homophones, buy, buy, and buy. The first buy is to purchase. It's irregular, buy, bought, bought. For example, don't forget to buy yogurt. The second buy is a preposition. For example, there is a bedside table next to my bed. And the third buy is this, buy. For example, bye, see you on Monday. Number 14, to wait and wait. The first example, please wait a moment. And the example for the second wait is she's lost a lot of weight. Let's continue. Number 15 is here and here. The first here is this, to hear. It's irregular, hear, heard, heard. For example, I can't hear you. Could you speak up? And the second here, here, for example, come here. Number 16, to meet and meet. The first meet is an irregular verb, to meet, met, met. For example, let's meet tomorrow. And the second meet is a kind of food. For example, I'm cutting down on meat. Let's continue number 17, to steal and steal. Pronunciation long E. The first is an irregular verb. To steal, stole, stolen. For example, he was accused of stealing public money. And the second, steal, is a kind of metal. For example, the door is made of steel. Let's continue another set of homophones, to see and see. The first see is an irregular verb, to see, saw, seen. For example, I can't see you. And the second see, an example sentence, the sea is choppy today. Second to last pair of homophones is to write and write. We don't pronounce W. The first one is also an irregular verb, to write, wrote, written. For example, please don't forget to write a composition. And the second, write, an example sentence, that's right. And last but not least, to sew and to sew. Exactly the same pronunciation, but different meanings. The first, to sew, is this. And it can be to sew, sewed, sewed, or to sew, sewed, sewn. Both are correct. For example, she loves sewing. And the second, to sew, means to put seeds in the ground. For example, I want to sow some carrot seeds. It can be also figurative. For example, he sowed doubt in my mind. So guys, I really hope you enjoyed this English bit. There are so many homophones in English, so if you want me to make another lesson with more, just let me know in the comments below. And of course, don't forget to like this video, to subscribe, to turn on the notifications, and check out my Instagram stories. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!